As a performing artist, just like me, you probably already had the displeasure of experiencing this terrible squeal that sometimes completely unexpectedly comes out of the speakers at your shows. And you are not alone. We've all been there, it's an issue known as audio feedback. Today I will explain to you what audio feedback is and give you all the tips you need to avoid it. After watching this video, you will never again be the cause of feedback problems.
Next gig is gonna be dynamite.
First, let me quickly explain what audio feedback actually is. Audio feedback happens when the output signal gets back to the input and, you probably guessed it, creates a loop. Let's take it step by step. In a live context, the microphone is picking up sound. That sound is then being amplified, comes out of a loudspeaker, and then gets picked up by the microphone again. This creates a loop which quickly turns into an oscillation at some frequency and causes that unpleasant squealing sound. Now, there are different scenarios on stage that might lead to this annoying feedback sound. Imagine that you're singing in a rock band and the guitar solo is about to kick in. You put the microphone away from your mouth and you instinctively put your hand down, because why would you hold a microphone up if you're not singing? Yeah, that's a trap.
It's a trap!
Your microphone now points at the monitor speaker on the stage and suddenly it's not your guitarist playing the solo anymore. Your microphone is. Because it fully picks up what's coming out of your monitor. The perfect loop, but the bad kind. Next trap. You notice a feedback sound building up. What do? You try to mute the microphone by covering it with your hand like this. Bad idea. That's pure feedback fuel. You've probably noticed that pointing the microphone in a certain direction can be the cause of the issue. That would imply that the microphone is deaf from the back. And actually, that's the case with majority of stage microphones. They use a so-called cardioid polar pattern. A cardioid pattern is sensitive to sound from the front and rejects the sound coming from the back. If you wanted to draw this polar pattern, it actually looks like a heart. It may sound schmaltzy as fuck, but music is love. So there are two takeaways. First, if you are using a cardioid microphone, let's make sure that its back is pointing towards the speaker to prevent feedback. Second, you should know that the polar pattern may change if you don't hold the microphone properly. Almost all microphones are designed to be held by the handle, not by the grill. If you grab it by the grill or completely cover it with your hand, the cardioid becomes an omni pattern and starts picking up sound from all directions. And then the mic screeches at you because it doesn't like being grabbed by the grill, obviously. There are a few other things that you should keep in mind if you want to prevent audio feedback issues. Here's a checklist with a few quick solutions. Listen to the sound guys and sound gals working at the venue. They know the setup best and they will instruct you on what to do and what not to do. Use your sound check time wisely and try to keep it as close to real performance as possible. Keep the same distance to the monitor while moving, hold your microphone the same way. This way your audio engineer will be able to set up everything correctly and minimize the chance of feedback occurring. Make your microphone technique as consistent as possible. Pay attention to the distance to your mic and your distance from any speakers on the stage. If you're holding the microphone in your hand, move the microphone away from the main speaker. The further your microphone is from the speakers, the less sound from them it will pick up. But what to do with the stage monitor? It needs to be close so that you can hear yourself while performing. It's not an option to move it further because otherwise you won't hear anything. And in that case, I would suggest doing the opposite. Just make sure that the monitor is as close as possible to you so it can stay as quiet as possible while you still hear yourself. Alternatively, it's also a good idea to try using in-ear monitors. This not only reduces the chance of feedback occurring, but also lowers the loudness levels on stage, which makes it much easier for your audio engineer to mix. So if in-ear monitors are an option, I would choose these. Now that you understand what audio feedback is and you know a few new tricks, the squeal will never ruin your confidence on stage again. Thank you for sticking with us. If you liked the video, then leave us some love below in the form of likes, comments, and subscriptions. See you next time!